Okay, here we are, Griswold EF&G series pumps. We're going to be showing you how to put a mechanical seal into it. The EF&G series pumps use either the JM or JP frame motors, and we'll be installing a John Crane Type 21 component seal.
Okay, what we have is a JM motor. I've already cleaned the shaft, I prepped the keyway. The next thing I want to do is add a few things to the shaft to make it easier for the build. We got two O-rings going to go on. That's going to go behind the sleeve when I put the seal on. Put a little lube on that so the sleeve fits over it. Fairly easy. Next thing I do, come over, get the bracket. Make sure the bracket is clean inside where the seal seat goes into. Pretty important. Next thing is I take the seal out of the box. This is the seal seat. And this, the white part's going to face up. This is the seal and spring assembly. That's going to go around the sleeve, which is right here. And it has this place where the O-rings are going to slip down into it from the shaft. We're going to stick that right there. Okay, first things, we're going to lube this seal. I'm trying to be very careful not to touch the face of the seal. You can touch it, but after it's installed, you can push it down with your thumbs. We have a tool that we use so that it goes nice and straight. We don't touch the seal as much. And it'll fit pretty flush. If you do touch the seal face, I like to use an alcohol prep. Especially if you're in the field and you got dirty hands and the like there. You just go over the top of the seal. And that'll take care of that. The next thing I do is I want to mount this pump itself. Four bolts. You gotta be real careful. Slide this over the shaft, not to bump that ceramic seat. Use your third arm here. Hold it up against the motor. This is a 184 JM motor from Wake. You want to get this fairly snug at the, so it stays straight. You have room for adjustment after you get the case on. Okay, once you get that set, you want to face that keyway, face it straight up so it's easier to align everything. And again, come back over here to the seat. You pop the little seat face off, leave the spring and the flat part. Get a little more lube, and I like to put just a little bit on the lip here, and then some on the outside of the sleeve. Then you put some on the rubber, on the seal itself. Then you slide it right over top of the sleeve. Be real careful because they're easy to break. Once you get that through there, push it through a little bit. Get a rag, make sure it's nice and clean at the seal face. And you want to push it through so that it sticks up above the sleeve. And then make sure it's nice and clean. Use that alcohol stuff again. The reason you want that clean, if you have oil on that seal, when you fire it up, it could burn the seal and cause a leak. Put the spring back on. Make sure that you have just a little bit of sleeve showing, so that when you put the key on, if this thing doesn't slide over. Reinstall it. You want to give yourself just a little bit of keyway. Let me get our bolt and our washer together. With a little bit of Loctite on the thread so it doesn't back off. And then we get our impeller. And our key. You take your key, put it inside so that the key just comes up just above the lip of the impeller. Then we set it all together. And with one motion, this here stainless piece of metal, you don't want that to drop between the impeller and the sleeve itself, or else your runout will be bad. So you want to do one quick motion until back in here, you'll see that the sleeve fits right over those O-rings you put in earlier. Then on, make sure your key's in, and you put your impeller bolt. Get your impact. That should do it. Should have a nice, easy spin on it. So now we can check our run out. Set this up, set it to zero. We have a maximum of 7 that we can go, 7,000. So we're right at 7. So that would be good to go.